Hello, my beautiful friends, and welcome back. So, over the past 8 years since I first started having sex, I have learned a lot. And had I known these things when I first started having sex, it would have made it so much more enjoyable for me. And I feel like I could have eliminated a lot of shitty experiences I have had through sex. So, I thought I would sit down today and share them with you guys. And I'm not talking about lube or masturbation, I'm talking about the nitty gritty. So, I'm going to share them with you guys today since our sex education freaking sucks. And I'm also going to link some videos down below that I have done talking about sex that I feel might be helpful for you guys. I did a whole video talking about being insecure about your vulva and down there, and yeah, I feel like it's a really important video. And you know the drill by now, YouTube is not a fan of these videos, so please engage with this video, give it a like, a comment, a share. We need to just show YouTube that this content is so important, because none of us got this information at the point in our lives when we should have got it, so it's better now than never. Right, let's dive right on in. So number one is, if you're someone who has sex with men, a lot of men will do almost anything to avoid using a condom. Please don't fall for it. If he's still capable of getting a hard on and having an orgasm while wearing a condom, it's clearly not doing too much to ruin his experience. If you are ever in a situation where a man tells you he can't really enjoy sex wearing a condom, tell him he's full of crap and break open the Durex. It still amazes me how many men will try to compromise on something that could result in an unwanted pregnancy or an STI. If he'd rather put you at risk or have you worrying during sex than ever so slightly reduce the feeling in his dick, then the sex isn't even remotely worth it, and I wouldn't even bother. And that's coming from somebody who did exactly that before. You know, I was in a situation with a guy and he said that, you know, condoms, and I went with it anyway. And then I spent about 2 weeks stressing, panic attacks, anxiety, worrying that I might have an STI, waiting for my results from the clinic. Like, you know, I disrespected myself in return. I let him disrespect me. It took me a really long time to forgive myself for that, because I crossed my boundaries, you know, and I let someone treat me in a way I wasn't okay with. And by the way, having to explain all this to a guy is the world's worst foreplay. I feel like it tells you everything about his character, you know, so just keep that in mind. Moving on. So how much sex you have is your decision, and you don't deserve to be labelled a prude or a slut because of it. The same woman can be called a prude and a slut on the same damn freaking day. Basically, if you have sex with a guy, you're a slut, and if you don't have sex with him, you're a prude. Women who make choices about their bodies should be celebrated and not ridiculed. I truly believe if there's one thing young girls should be taught, it's that labels like prude and slut have been created by men who are afraid of the power of women's sexuality and have no basis in fact. Okay, so number three is, educating yourself gives you confidence in the bedroom and most importantly in your sexuality. Because most of us got next to no sex education, a lot of us don't even know where to begin. You do not come out of the womb knowing how to suck a dick, or even knowing how to make yourself orgasm for that matter. Like, sex is just like anything else. You know, if you're not taught about it and you don't learn about it and you don't have knowledge about it, how the hell are you supposed to know what you're meant to do? These are some of the questions that I get asked on a regular basis, and it's all well and good being told to masturbate or to find out what you like in the bedroom, but if you don't know how to masturbate, or you don't know what variety there is in the bedroom and what your different options are in the bedroom, that's a near impossible task to ask of somebody. And then to ask somebody to communicate that to their partner is even more difficult, because where the hell are you meant to be? Yeah. Knowledge equals confidence. For example, if you study for an exam, you're going to be so much more relaxed and confident going in versus if you don't study for an exam. The same applies to sex. You know, if you have knowledge on the subject, you're going to be a lot more confident walking into the bedroom and a lot more relaxed. Whereas if you don't, you know, have knowledge and aren't educated on the topic, you're going to be pretty anxious, pretty nervous, pretty stressed going into the bedroom, into the environment. And this is where I would like to thank Beducated for sponsoring today's video. So if you've never heard of Beducated, it's basically the Netflix of sexual wellness. They have a bunch of online courses on sex education. It is literally a website that I would have made. Exactly how they've done it, to the T, it is everything I have ever wanted in sex education and so much more. So their online course platform provides super easy to follow video, audio and written guides, which provide techniques and all the information you know and never got about sex education. A lot of you guys seem to really struggle in your relationship communicating or even knowing what you want in the bedroom, so therefore it's even harder to communicate to your partner. But they have so many amazing courses for couples. They have like 42 courses for couples, from like oral sex to kink to tantra to BDSM. Like, they have it all. Female pleasure, It's actually insane. I have been really enjoying the kink course. I have been finding out some new kinks about me that I didn't know. Also, the female pleasure one is so freaking interesting. Like, there's even like little techniques in there that I was like, oh, I'm gonna have to try that one
The
out.
educator believes that sexual happiness is trainable, and so do I,
because as I was saying, you don't come out of the womb knowing what you're gonna do. You've gotta teach yourself, you've gotta educate yourself, you've gotta build up that knowledge in your brain. There's so much to learn about sex. And even I was going through some of the courses and I was like, I didn't know about this because it's not spoken about anywhere. And
porn is not sexual education, and unfortunately, a lot of us have used it as sexual education over the years because there has been no other information out there.
And I feel like that's what can really damage a lot of couples' sex lives. Whereas I feel like Beducated, like this online platform, is amazing to sit down with your partner and go through some of the courses because it's a lot easier to have someone else. You know, if you have someone else explaining like your little techniques for oral, right? And then you could go to your partner, I would love if we could try that. And like, you know, so you're doing it outside the bedroom, but then you're able to incorporate it into the bedroom, you know? So
It really will help you experience a stronger connection and just make you more sexually fulfilled, because at the end of the day, your sexual happiness is so
And
important.
of course, it's not just for couples. They also have a bunch of courses on there for singles, so you can learn what you like and then bring that into the bedroom. You know, they go into how to pleasure yourself, female pleasure, oral, kissing, dating. They have it all. But yeah, you can actually get Beducated for 1 day free, and you can also get 70% off the yearly pass with my code Jessie. So you can try the course out for a day, and if it's not your cup of tea, you can cancel it and you will not be charged a penny. So definitely recommend checking it out, because you would be able to take a few courses even in a day and see if it's your thing or not, and then make your decision from
This is
there.
information that is just not out there. Like, I can't sit here and show you how to suck a dick. Do you know what I mean? It's just not appropriate.
Whereas Beducated can, like, they literally physically do. So honey, get on that. You know, if you're struggling about what you like, you don't know how to get yourself off, it's all there.
Okay, so number four is penetration is only one kind of sex. Oral sex, anal sex, it's all sex. You do not need to be penetrated by a dildo, a penis, or a finger to have
In
sex.
fact, you don't need to be touched at all to have a sexual experience. I wish that I knew how much of an amazing out of this world experience it would be to masturbate with your partner. It all counts. And as a bisexual woman, I was often made feel throughout my life that my experience with women didn't count. I'm sorry, but what a load of absolute shit.
Right, so number five is orgasms are not required. And I've personally never heard anyone talk about this, but I feel like it's so
I've
important.
only started having partnered orgasms regularly in the last 6 months, but I didn't spend 7 years having bad sex. It was exploratory
It
sex.
was experimental sex. It was discover what I really freaking like sex.
One thing I've learned during that time is that orgasm chasing is never a good idea. And where sex is concerned, pleasure is the main point. And you get to decide what is pleasurable for you. And sometimes that will result in orgasm, and sometimes it won't end in
I
orgasm.
definitely went through a period in my life where I was chasing the orgasm during sex, and I feel like it definitely took away from the experience. And I feel like I also nearly put a block in my brain, which resulted in me not being able to orgasm because I was so focused on it that I wasn't just relaxing and enjoying the experience and enjoying the pleasure and just, you know, enjoying each moment. It's not always about the orgasm, and I feel like the orgasm is always just pushed in our face, and you know, you can feel really less than if you're not having orgasms. But I'm here to tell you that it's okay. Like, I've had some amazing sex where I've not had an orgasm. So, you heard it here first.
Moving on, everyone's body is different when it comes to birth control. When I was in secondary school, so like high school, I was basically told that the pill was like a miracle drug. But everyone's body is so different, and I wish I knew that, you know, that while a lot of women might get zero side effects from the pill, many women will experience debilitating conditions from it. And I was one of those people, and I let it slide for so many years, not linking what I was struggling with to the pill and not linking my mental health decline to the pill, because I wasn't educated, I wasn't informed on the side effects that the pill can have on you and how much it can affect you. It's not going to affect everyone, just like the IUD might be amazing for some women, and then for other women, it might cause them absolute hell. Basically, the bottom line is when it comes to birth control, there is absolutely no one size fits all, and nobody, and I mean nobody, knows your body better than you. You know, I was pressured to go back on the pill from my previous ex-boyfriend, and you know, I knew that I shouldn't do it.
everything in my body was telling me not to do it because I knew how badly it affected me when I was on it for 5 years prior. And he kept pushing and pushing, so I went on it. And again, you know, it only in the last number of months I'm still coming out of what the pill did to my body, because it doesn't agree with my body. So you know, it's a lot of elimination, trying and eliminating products, and you know, what works for someone else isn't going to necessarily work for you. So don't listen to what other people are taking for birth control, but listen to what your body needs for your birth control. And then moving on to number 7 is that everyone else is not having more or better sex than you. There is no normal amount we should all aspire to. There is no magic number times a month that signifies your relationship is hunky-dory. You know, if you're having sex 15 times a month, oh, that means your relationship is all good. The only thing that matters and the only question you should be asking is, are you having enough sex for you? If the answer is yes, hunky-dory. And if it's no, well, then that's something you've got to work on. But, you know, everyone else, they're not having more or better. It's just the way society likes to portray it to you, to sell you things and, you know, all that jazz. But yeah, there are 7 things that I've learned in the last 8 years having sex, things that I don't feel are as touched on. They're a little bit more specific. I definitely have a bunch more I could share with you guys if you're interested. I did share 10 things I wish I knew before having sex last year, and you guys really loved that video. And I just love talking about these topics on my channel because, you know, it really opens up the conversation, it creates a comfortable environment for us to discuss things and just, like, you know, be fucking free, you know. But friends, I genuinely could not recommend Beducated enough. Whether you're a beginner or you've been having sex for the last 20 odd years, there is going to be something in there that you didn't know or that will help you when it comes to the bedroom. So yeah, you can get 1 day free and then 70% off the yearly pass with my code Jessie. So definitely check the link down below in my description, and thank you guys so much for working with me. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and maybe learn something new, and let me know if you would like to see more videos like this in the future. Thank you so much for watching, and I love you all so very much. Bye bye, friends.